Folks, welcome to the Great Northwest and Spokane Veterans Memorial Arena. We have a game with major playoff implications here tonight, and it's a rivalry showdown between the Portland Thunder and the Spokane Shock. Sam Adams, Mike Peterson here on a Saturday evening. Thank you for joining us. We talk about the Spokane Shock, a team that is coming off an upset win against Arizona, the defending Arena Bowl champions, and the number one team in all arena football. San Jose barely held off Portland in overtime. So two hot teams going head-to-head, and let's get right to it. For Portland, a familiar face at quarterback. We saw him in years past, a former Arena Bowl MVP in Kyle Rowley.
And Kyle Rowley has spent a lot of his career right here in Spokane, AF2 and AFL. And his exploits have hung many banners here in the Spokane Arena. But tonight he comes in with Portland. Rowley, he's a wily veteran. He is hot and he is cold. And when he is hot, he's going to rack up the points. So the question is, which Kyle Rowley shows up tonight? If it's the hot Kyle Rowley, Spokane's defense is going to have their hands very, very full.
And which quarterback literally will show up for Spokane? Well, it's been a revolving door of quarterbacks. But for a second week in a row, Arvell Nelson gets the start. He's 1-0 as an AFL starting quarterback in his career after that win against the Rattlers. And boy, oh boy, did he have a connection last week with Anthony Amos.
You are looking at Spokane's dynamic duo from last week. And you see the numbers that Nelson to Amos put up. And those numbers from Amos earned him AFL Offensive Player of the Week honors. Nelson got it done on the ground, rush for a couple touchdowns with his arm. And it's amazing because even though he's a veteran in the AFL, it literally was his rookie start and he came out shining.
Well, Spokane with a win tonight will lock up a top four playoff spot in the AFL postseason. Portland, if it loses, needs a whole lot of help to get back in that picture. When we come back, we'll kick things off from the arena between Spokane and Portland. All right, we talked about it in the open, and we are ready for some AFL action. Major playoff implications here this evening between Spokane and Portland, playing with basically their playoff lives hanging in the balance for Portland. And meanwhile, for the Shock, at 5-10, right now just a game ahead of Portland, and with a win, will clinch at least the number four seed in the AFL postseason. But Mike, you don't need to tell either of these teams what's at stake here tonight.
No, this is playoff football. Even though it's the end of the regular season, oftentimes teams in this situation at the end of the regular season, it's what they talk about. It's playoff time. Tonight is no exception.
And for what it's worth, the Shock have won the coin flip. They have deferred, so they will kick off. And almost not fair when you have Radical Rick from the Spokane Shock fan club doing the coin flip. I don't know, maybe you want to find him on the craps table over at Northern Quest. He rolled up a tails for these guys, so perhaps unfair home advantage for Spokane against Portland.
Taylor Rowan, kicker for Spokane, hit the bar multiple times last week.
And there's another one. It's our kickoff sponsored by your locally owned Napa Auto Parts stores. Shard Dodd Masters and Company with a not-so-warm greeting to Spokane.
Lonely feeling as a kicker when that ball hits the bar and you know you're going to get just belted as he did by Dodd Masters.
So our first look right now at Kyle Rowley, former Arena Bowl MVP for the Shock, and coming off an impressive performance, though it did not net him a win. And recently, just in that performance against San Jose, eclipsing 19,000 passing yards and 400 career passing touchdowns. First and 10 from the 2 along the far side and complete just shy of the 10-yard line. 5-yard pickup as we take a look at the Portland Thunder offense. It will be Ashford, Lacey, Perry, the receivers. Martinez in the backfield as the fullback. McDonough, Collins, and Longo. They've done a very good job of protecting the quarterback this year. 16 sacks allowed, fifth best in arena football.
Perry and Lacey at wide receiver are two outstanding targets for Kyle Rowley.
Second down and 4. Perry is the motion man. They'll run a screen, little bobble. Rashard Dodd Masters trying to get the tackle and running right through that tackle is Ashford as he picks up the first down up to the 17-yard line.
Dodd Masters, he's a big hitter, but you have to wrap up and look at the physicality. There's the bobble, a big hit, but able to keep his feet spin and get extra yardage. That is a physical play by Ashford. Dodd Masters has to wrap up there.
So up to the 17-yard line as Portland picks up its first down of the ball game. Quick two-step drop. Dodd Masters again with the tackle along the dasher board as Lacey picks up his first reception. Take a look at the Spokane defense, which has forced a league-high 17 fumbles this season. Ruffin, Taylor, and King, maybe the best down linemen in all of arena football. Summers and McCullough, the linebackers, Dodd Masters, McMillan, and Gilliam, a secondary that has been in flux, but they feel like maybe they have found the answer.
Well, you said Spokane, known for forcing a lot of fumbles. They also want to force some interceptions tonight.
Rally quick throw again. This one is caught by Ashford. Ashford well past the first down marker, so another conversion here for the Thunder offense, which is clicking on this opening possession.
Indeed, they are clicking. Kyle Rowley looking very sharp and very efficient on this opening drive. He's getting rid of the ball very quickly. His reads have been spot on. His accuracy has been impeccable so far.
Perry already over 1,000 yards on the season. Lacey on the cusp. He has 949 coming into the ballgame. Balanced attack between Lacey and Perry. First and 10 from the Shock 18. The throw is to Perry in the end zone. Incomplete, let's see. Held on, did he? Yes, he did. What a grab from Perry for the touchdown.
Perry isolated in high motion on the right side. You'll see that on the replay. Runs a corner out, and Rowley releasing the ball before the final cut. Indefensible. So we'll watch Perry, high motion, isolated on the right side. The release about right now. See the head snapper out. That is just perfect location. And a tough Perry cradling that ball over the dasher board and holding on. That's concrete below the dasher board.
Martinez off the net, no good on the point after as we send you to break. And a look at our VPI Windows Custom Fit for Life scoreboard. Over the wall and in for the touchdown. 6-0 Portland. Welcome back. Here's a look at our VPI Home Solutions scoring recap. Five plays, 48 yards, capped off by an 18-yard touchdown pass from Kyle Rowley. And it goes to Perry. So Jared Perry with his 25th touchdown reception on the season as Portland draws first blood here in Spokane.
And falling into the Spokane team box, and you can see that is just pure concrete underneath his feet there. That is not a soft landing.
Zach Ramirez to kick. And through the slack net, so no return from Anthony Amos. So our first look now at the Spokane Shock offense as late flags come in. Our officials are Scott Campbell, Al Granato, Mike Chase, Michael Livingston, Craig Faulkner, and Dave Chesney.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 4, Portland. 10 yards, the 5-yard line, first down.
And that's Osaji Odiasi, a defensive back out of Sacramento State. Arvell Nelson, second career AFL start as a QB. What you don't see there besides the 7 touchdowns and 2 interceptions are the 4 rushing touchdowns. Spokane has struggled inside the red zone. He adds a different and new dynamic to this offense.
That rushing element is a big X factor. It was last week against Arizona.
Nelson tried to take off and run as he's wrangled up by Casey Obi. Let's take a look at the starting offense for Spokane. Truesdell, Carter, and Amos, the wide receivers. Bryson Kelly, a fullback. We expect to see a lot of him running the football tonight. Afif Nixon getting the start at center, and Gallatin on the end.
And Sam, as you mentioned, Nixon, normally the fullback with Tapua out, has to move to center tonight.
Here's Carter with the catch along the dasher board as he hangs on for the first down. So Spokane converts on second down and 10. Fan appreciation night here inside the arena as we have another look at the quick drop from Nelson.
Just a timing route, indefensible when you have that kind of execution. First down for Spokane.
Coverage by Dwight McLean, but again, a first down for the Shock. They're in Portland territory, and here's Kelly. You don't see a lot of running in arena football unless it's a goal-to-go situation or third and one, fourth and one, but Spokane perhaps adding a new wrinkle to its arena offense.
You're going to see a lot of Kelly. Well, Coach Olson, also the offensive coordinator, rolled out a lot of the run game last week, and it really threw Arizona off in the Arizona loss.
Here's a throw, a little miscommunication between Nelson and Carter. Carter was turned around to the right, and Nelson threw left. Take a look at the Portland Thunder starting defense. On the line, it will be Hayes, Trotter, and Jackson. The linebackers, Obi and Bryce Pila. And then the defensive secondary, McLean, Sonny, and Glanton.
And number 10, Sony at the middle defensive back position. He's going to remind fans a lot of Paul Stevens, outstanding cover guy, and expect Portland to run more man-to-man with Sony in there.
Here's Amos, juggling catch along the dasher board. He hangs on and picks up the first down, gain of 13 for the reigning offensive player of the week, Anthony Amos.
And this is that play where you just dump it in over the top of the Jack linebacker and right in between the under coverage and the over-the-top coverage.
So the Shock are inside the KFC red zone. First down, goal to go from the 9. Nelson under pressure, and he's tied up, brought down on the sack by Frank Trotter, the defensive line.
And that's a coverage sack there. There was excellent coverage by the Portland DBs. No one open. Nelson tried to buy time, obviously got ran down from behind by the back edge, by the backside.
Second down.
The edge rusher.
That's 31 sacks allowed by Spokane. Second most in all of arena football.
Spokane last in AFL in red zone efficiency, and on that first play, you just can't take those negative yardage plays.
It's a loss of 6 on the play. Multiple flags coming in. And on the run is Nelson. Nelson inside the 10. His two defenders just went head to head. Both are very woozy.
Oh, they both took a shot. Jack linebacker and defensive lineman.
One was Trotter, 52 and 20. That would be Pila.
And Pila taking a knee. They blew up each other.
Offense, 5-yard penalty from the previous spot, still second down.
Now, I did not catch real time what the illegal formation was, but two flags went down, so obviously it was something.
Well, we saw Amos had a look like he was going to be the motion man, then line up on the line as the receiver, and then Carter was the high motion man. So somewhere in there, I believe the illegal formation happened.
Well, Sam, as you describe it, then you've got perhaps two guys in motion. Regardless, negative for Spokane.
Second down and long. Picked off at the 5-yard line. It was intended for Truesdale. Instead, it goes to Dwight McLean. McLean all the way past the 20-yard line as Portland comes up with a huge interception.
Anytime, and it doesn't matter indoor or outdoor, you float a ball over the middle, bad things happen. That was good for Portland, not so good for Spokane.
So a costly turnover for Spokane on its opening possession. Portland football when we come back. All right, arena fans, Mike Peterson has your keys to the game. They are brought to you by Spokane Boys, your answer for all seasons.
Well, 50 has been a magic number for Portland. 0 wins, 10 losses when given up 50 or more defensively. So we're going to keep an eye on that number. And Nelson, still virtually, he's a rookie quarterback in this league. Keep up the pressure. We saw in that last drive, 3 hurries, a sack, and a red zone stop.
So Kyle Rally back under center after directing a perfect drive to start this ball game. This his first incomplete pass. Rally now 5 of 6, 48 yards and one touchdown. Rally has been impressive. When he does not play well, he tends to play poorly. I know that kind of seems like the no-duh statement, but he is truly the ultimate. When he's hot, he's hot. When he's cold. There's not a whole lot of middle ground with Kyle Rally. Second down and 10. Portland leading 6-0 here. Second offensive possession. Screen pass. Well designed. Dwayne Brooks with a catch pass midfield. Take a look now as we continue the keys to the game.
Spokane's got it. You need a bunch of ball hawks in the secondary. Rally's been prone to throwing interceptions, a 4-1 TD to interception ratio, and he's streaky. One interception usually leads to multiple INTs. Spokane's got to execute in the red zone. Ideally, you're perfect because you're going to get that score over 50, which has been that magic number for Portland. Already a fail for Spokane in that category.
Jared Perry, the motion man. Rally under pressure, dumps it off over the middle. It's complete. Dwayne Brooks with a catch. Finally brought down inside the 10-yard line. Gain of 14 on 3rd and 5.
The experience and wiliness of Kyle Rally came up huge on that play. You'll see Ruffin on the outside edge coming hard. Rally saw that, shuffled underneath to his left, bought time, and was able to get a big play there instead of just sitting in the pocket.
The spot is just outside of the 10-yard line, so it is a first down and 10, not goal, first and 10 for Portland. Rally hands off. And a run by Martinez, doesn't go much of anywhere, maybe 2 yards.
Tackle on the play by number 56, Derek Summers.
Martinez, the team's leading rusher. That's 39 carries, 61 yards on the season. Martinez does have 13 rushing touchdowns on the year.
This is where you make a difference. Come on!
Spokane fell behind early to Arizona last week in that win. They ultimately won that game 52-45, but they trailed at one point 20-7. Rally. Pass to the 5-yard line. And down at the 4 is Brooks.
Good pass protection by the Portland Thunder so far tonight. And it's buying Rally time. He's able to read the field and find open receivers.
Another third down. This will be a 3rd and goal from the 4.
Difference so far has been Portland offensive line has protected and the Portland defensive line has put pressure on the Spokane quarterback. That's been the big story.
5 on the play clock. The motion man is Lacy. They just get the play off. Flags come in, throw into the end zone. Simultaneous, let's see who comes up with it. And initially ruled a touchdown. Lacy with the catch. Now the only question is who the penalty will be on. I don't think it's delay of game.
Offsides, number 26, defense.
So that's on McMillan, the defensive back, so the touchdown will stand. Well, Portland, its offense has come out firing on all cylinders.
Incredibly efficient, and once again, you're gonna see going to the high motion man, well thrown outside shoulder, 50-50 ball, but when it's thrown that well, and you've got a receiver such as Lacy, that's more than a 50-50 ball, about a 90-10 ball.
Ramirez on for a second point after. This one is through the slack net and good. Rally directs another touchdown drive, and with 2:47 to play in the quarter, it is 13-0 Portland. Kyle Rally, an impressive 9-for-10 throwing the football, 75 yards and a pair of touchdowns. And that's where things stand as Anthony Amos is back to return for Spokane. 13-0 Thunder here on the road. Ramirez, high kick. And off the bar ball, dangerous ball, and it'll be recovered by Amos momentarily. Tried to pick it up off the fly, and it goes right into the clutches of the Portland coverage team. So it's recovered by Ramirez, the kicker. Boy, oh boy.
But it will be Spokane's ball because it's a loose ball, hits the dasher board.
So it's still a kick. Anytime a kick goes into the wall, it is dead by roll. Spokane's ball, first down.
Johnny on the spot, Mike Peterson. We'll take the media timeout. Spokane dodges a bullet, trails by 13. Fan appreciation night, great crowd on hand here in what we call Death Valley. Spokane, Washington, the home of the Shock, as they come in at 5-10, but right now holding on to the number 3 seed in the National Conference.
So, Sam, just to clarify the kickoff in AFL, until the ball is possessed by the receiving team, that ball is considered a free ball. And a free ball on a kickoff that goes into the dasher board immediately is a dead ball and automatically goes to the receiving team. That's why Spokane has the ball there on the 10-yard line. So you'll see. Yeah, that was close. So the question was, did he possess it? I'd like to take another look at that. But it looks like he never did tuck it away. So that would still be a loose ball.
Miscommunication between Nelson and Carter again. Second time that they have failed to be on the same page. Now Nelson just making his second career start as a quarterback in the Arena Football League. And number 13, Carter, just his second game back after thumb surgery, cost him half a dozen games here in this 2015 campaign. So those two guys trying to get back on the same page. Second down and 10 for the Shock, trailing 13-0. Amos, the motion man, the pitch, and the run by Bryson Kelly.
Bryson Kelly on the run.
He got darn near 70 yards on that run. Talk about your safety valve in arena football. There is no tight end. And really, there is no running game when you think about it. But the Shocks say, you know what? We may just rewrite the rule book here. We will run the football on second down. Third down and 3. Amos again, the motion man. Here is the throw to Amos. He catches it. And he'll get the first down.
Anthony Amos once again in the tackle. We're on reception tackle on the play by Virgil Saudi.
Well, we're seeing shades of what we saw from Arvell Nelson in that come-from-behind victory against Arizona. A start that wasn't the best, though. It was more, if we're going to be completely honest, more on the receivers last week at the beginning, but then they started to get in too. To see how this game unfolds.
You said Spokane down 20-7, and on that toss where Kelly got 7 yards, actually a fumble. And there's a little screen pass that was sniffed out by number 45 of Portland and knocked down.
So Adrian Hamilton breaks that pass up. There's Andy Olson tutoring his young quarterback, Arvell Nelson. Nelson, a mid-season acquisition, had been listed and been a part of the Spokane Shock as far as rights go for a player, but only at mid-season deciding to leave Ohio to come back to play for the Shock. And now he's in the starting lineup. Second down and 10. Quick throw. This is Nick Truesdale. Truesdale's first catch. Boy, oh boy, some extracurriculars going on between he and Pelet, though it is a clean play.
Two physical guys, Pelet, Jack linebacker, Truesdale, wide receiver.
And that'll take us to our first commercial break after the quarter. So at the end of one, Portland leads it 13-0. Spokane ball when we come back. Riverfront Park. Boy, oh boy, those are some well-oiled machines out there.
I'm liking the looks of those sports cars.
Some classics, some new ones, just like Spokane. So we welcome you back. Some veterans, some new guys. They hope they found the right mix down the stretch. Shock football, third down and 5 as we start the second quarter. Nelson looking with time. Leaping catch. What a grab. Amos was on the turf and somehow, despite that, stretched out and made the catch. and it's enough for a first down.
To see Nelson looking left, checking off to the right, and Amos just laying out, getting both hands. Phenomenal catch.
Amos with a flair for the dramatic. He knows how to make those big-time clutch catches. First and 10 from the 14. Screen pass, Amos to the 10, dances his way near the 7-yard line. Anthony Amos coming off a career performance. Career highs in the AFL, 13 catches, 144 yards, and three scores in that win against Arizona.
Do we have a timeout called here?
We have a player down for Portland near the 8-yard line. Looks like Casey Obie, the defensive lineman, will take the injury timeout with 14:11 to play here in the second quarter. Portland defensive lineman Casey Obie being helped off the field after that injury during the, and now an injury timeout.
He was in pursuit, and you'll see, there he is. He goes for the tackle, misses, goes into the dasherboard, and you can see hits that right shoulder and then he'll start walking away, but then goes to the ground. That could be a shoulder stinger. That actually could sometimes go all the way down to the spine into the lower back, but it's a good sign to see him walk off on his own power.
Meanwhile, Spokane now is inside the KFC red zone from the 6-yard line in Portland territory. Give is to Kelly. Kelly Rembling. Can he get in? He does. He was a standout running back at Central Washington. Bryson Kelly in for the score, and the Shock are on the board.
Spokane, going back 10 years ago in the AF2, has notoriously been a very effective passing team, rarely relying on the run, but with Kelly back in the backfield, that's really changed things for Spokane.
Taylor Rowan's kick is good. Spokane now climbs within six. We have another look at the Kelly touchdown run.
Yeah, he's just keeping his legs going. And if you're going to go high on Kelly, you're not going to win that battle. And you can just see, just fighting with the legs.
And give the assist to Gallington, number 66, to help push the defensive lineman and thus Kelly into the end zone. The dominoes fell on that play.
They did, ending in the end zone, which is where Spokane finally wanted to go, in the red zone.
Kelly had 246 rushing yards in a game. One game, it's the fifth most in Central Washington history. Typically, when you see, Mike, a guy who is a standout runner in college, they find another position, and they didn't sign him for other positions. They want to put him in on the line. But Kelly has really found a new home as a fullback here.
Yeah, Kelly's played a lot defensively, and as you say, Sam, they've realized how good a runner he is and taken full advantage of that running ability. And it has completely changed the dynamic of the Spokane offense with Kelly running the ball.
Fan appreciation night. We've got a wave going inside Spokane Veterans Memorial Arena. Feel free to join in at home. Maybe those of you in Portland watching right now on Comcast Sportsnet Northwest from the sports page in Beaverton. Special warm welcome to you Thunder fans watching in Beaverton. Rowan to kick. Into the slack net, we'll have a touchback for Portland. No return for Brooks. How good has Kyle Rally been thus far for Portland?
Kyle Rally has been dynamite for the Portland Thunder, as has his offensive line and his receiving core.
Rally coming into the contest just under 3,000 yards passing on the season. Now over that, of course, 56 touchdowns and 18 interceptions.
And that's the ratio that's concerning. When you see a touchdown to interception ratio like that, if you look at the league leaders, you look at Merrick Meyer, he's about a 13-1 TD to interception ratio. But Kyle Rowley's a veteran. If he's streaky hot, he's as good as any.
Rally to throw, wide open receiver over the middle. That's Ashford. Perez Ashford picks up 9 on the play. So Spokane and Portland separated by a scant game in the National Conference standings. 5-10 for the Shock, 4-11 for Portland. They do play in the same division, the Pacific Division, where San Jose, a long time ago, locked up that division title and well on its way now to a number one seed. But Spokane and Portland are playing for a playoff spot here tonight with three games to go in the season. Ashford again the catch, and he's been the go-to man so far from Portland tonight after another pickup of 10 this time up to midfield.
Quick hitters, three-step out of the hand. Gilliam on the right side for Spokane, giving a lot of cushion on the outside. Rowley quickly reading it, just delivering the ball to the outside. That's easy pickings, easy yardage.
Gilliam second on the team in tackles with 50 on the season for Spokane. Rashard Dodd Masters leads the Shock with 62. Rowley again with time down the dasher board and caught. What a grab by Vakian Lacey down to the 12-yard line.
That is an unbelievable catch by Lacey. We saw an unbelievable catch on that touchdown throw on Portland's second touchdown. Look at this one-hander on the board. I thought Dodd Masters might have been called for a PI. Let's look at this.
Wow. Use the dasher board. It is your friend.
And that ball is corralled.
13 yards for the first down. Thunder all the way up to the Shock 12. 10:45 to play in the second. Rally, deep drop on the screen pass, and it's Martinez tripped up by Gilliam inside the five.
How's that for some agility by Martinez? You can see why they want to get him the ball.
Martinez listed at 6'2", 325 pounds. Went over Gilliam, but not all the way over. He's not going to win any high jump contests.
But 325 pounds of mass, showing a little bit of agility there.
I'd say for 325, that's some vertical lift.
That's pretty doggone good in my book.
Second and short. Martinez on the handoff. He's going to get into the end zone. McCullough got a hand on him as he made his way into the end zone as Martinez scores on the ground. And Portland is now up 19-7.
Well, Portland answering Spokane's TD run with a very impressive run of their own, going to the big guy on two consecutive plays.
That's got to be rare to go to a guy who's 325 pounds two times in a row.
I wouldn't want to try to tackle that, Sam.
I wouldn't want to get anywhere near that. 13-point lead for Portland. 20-7 on your VPI Windows custom Fit for Life scoreboard. Portland in control here early in the second. There's a look at Mike Hohensee, head coach for Portland. His first season with the Thunder as their head coach, but Mike, well-traveled. You've actually had your paths crossed with him early in his career.
Well, if you look at that, 1982, Washington State University, we went on the road, played in the Metrodome against Hohensee, who was a quarterback of the Gophers, and they took it to us. They came out victorious, heck of a quarterback in his day, and you could see his professional career as well.
And he also threw the first touchdown pass in Arena Football League history.
That's a great bit of trivia there, Sam.
Well, I guess it would have been trivia had I actually asked the question. Instead, I just gave the answer. Here's Amos out of the end zone to the 10, to the 15, and he's stopped in his tracks by Bryce Pila, who had a touchdown-saving tackle for Portland.
Pila has been a busy man tonight on defense and special teams.
While Amos has taken over kick return duties from Rashard Dodd Masters, he gets the return out to the 15-yard line. It's a heck of a return by that young man. He has started every game this season except for the season opener. He's been Spokane's most consistent receiver this season. Drive starts from their own 15-yard line. Nelson throws, it's Truesdell. There is a flag back towards the line of scrimmage. Ball's loose on the turf, and it's going to be recovered by Portland.
And we have a flag, and I'm sure it's going to be an offensive lineman for Spokane, illegal hands to the face. And if Portland recovered, I believe this is going to hold up. And, Sam, this is exactly where Spokane was against Arizona. Down 20-7, had the ball, fumbled. Then the defense made a great play, and Spokane had that come-from-behind victory. But this is deja vu in back-to-back weeks for Spokane.
The ruling on the field was a catch by Spokane and a fumble recovered by Portland. Personal foul, number 42, Spokane with a leg whip. That penalty will be enforced half the distance of the ball. Portland's ball, first down.
Well, I guess we just... Hopefully, if you're Spokane, you just re-cue exactly what happened a week ago.
And Truesdell just trying to fight for extra yardage. I couldn't quite tell how the ball came loose, but here we're going to have a look at this. Maybe see, there's your leg whip right there. Yep, just never got that ball fully tucked away as he was fighting for extra yardage. You can see too many white shirts against the dasherboard.
Portland in great shape right now, inside the red zone, at the Spokane 7-yard line. Uh-oh, ball's on the turf. Rally, I think, got to it, though. He tried to get it to Martinez on the flip, and Rally jumped in it like a dog in the middle of a fight going for a bone, and he came up with it.
Now, Sam, on Truesdell's fumble, and again, we're looking at the backside, so we can't see the front side, but you can see Truesdell's head snap a little bit. So if we can, let's look at a different camera angle and see if there was a face mask prior to the fumble.
Well, it'll be second down and goal from the shock 11-yard line. The throw into the end zone to Perry. No, oh, there's a flag that comes in. Very late towards the end zone. Looks like that could be pass interference.
And even though that came from the line judge who's 15 yards away, I have a hard time disagreeing with
pass
the call.
Pass interference, number 26. Defense, half the distance to the goal, automatic, first down.
Now, Mike, typically that would come from the back judge, Craig Faulkner, but not this case. It seemed like Mike Livingston had the better angle on it.
Yeah, and you that's can see clearly hole. A wrap. That's what I'm saying. It's I cannot disagree at all with that call. And look at the replay. There you go. Clear video evidence that it was pass interference.
No argument from Spokane here. First and goal from the shock 5. Two on the play clock. They barely get this one off. Rally throws, caught. Dodd Masters with the stop at the 3. Caught by Brooks.
Portland running that quick hitting offense. A lot of steady dose of 1 and 3 step drops. Just get the ball out of your hand quick. Rely on the accurate reads of Kyle Rowley and accurate passes. They're really taking to Spokane so far.
Second and goal from the Spokane 2-yard line. Rally just throws that one away. That's a souvenir football. There is a flag on the play. Gilliam saying it's against Portland.
Personal foul. Chop block, number 9, offense. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Still second down.
Well, there is a Jake McDonough who's listed as a defensive lineman, and he was on the football field. So, yes, it is against McDonough.
So here we go, number 9, right guard. Oh, and
he didn't even get anybody.
I don't know if he just chopped the turf, but he sure didn't chop a player. That's a huge break for Spokane. That looked like an absolute phantom flag from that replay.
Second and goal from the 13 to the end zone. And McMillan's going to be flagged for another pass interference call. This one looked more inadvertent than anything with him and Jared Perry.
Or actually, I believe that was Dodd Masters on the play, and regardless, it was unnecessary. That ball was overthrown. So good call, Sam. Indeed, that was McMillan. So him and Dodd Masters right there together. But let's look at this. You can see where that ball is thrown. And overthrown, unnecessary, and there you go.
That's three penalties called in a row. So Portland trying to take advantage on a fresh set of downs, first and goal from the six. Perry in high motion. Screen pass, incomplete. McDonough, the intended receiver.
And McCullough chainsaw sniffing that out at the Jack linebacker position.
Tell you what, Portland has really struggled taking care of the football this season. Minus 14 on the turnover margin coming into the contest. That's worse in all of arena football. But tonight, Mike, the Thunder are plus two in that category.
With that big interception when Spokane had that red zone visit, and then, of course, the fumble by Truesdell.
Second and goal from the Spokane six. Rally with time into the end zone, tipped and incomplete. Gilliam broke it up.
And Gilliam, one of the taller defensive backs in the league, has very long arms like what you'd see with a basketball player, and just knocking that ball away. Excellent man-to-man coverage across the board by Spokane.
Look at him come in and break up that pass intended for Jared Perry. Third and goal from the six. Fan appreciation night. The players appreciating the fans right now.
And timeout
just to beat the delay of game.
First of the half.
And small, smart play call by Portland going with the timeout. Kasam, as you said, that play clock was winding down. You cannot give up negative yardage in the red zone.
4:01 to play in the second quarter. Portland leading 20-7. It's a view of Riverfront Park.
That is a fun gondola ride if you haven't been in it.
The fall's not quite rushing like they are typically this time of year. Of course, a very short winter and an early start to summer. Some cool temperatures here today in the mid-70s. So Portland might be right at home here in Spokane.
A little bit of rain, some thunder in the air, and a lot of thunder inside tonight.
Thunder are rolling right now, leading 20-7. And really a critical third and goal from the Spokane six. Rally directing the offense.
This is where Spokane needs a pass rush.
Oh, they jumped the gun a little bit. Free play for Rally into the end zone. They whistle the play dead.
That's a live ball. There was no contact by the defense.
Offsides, number 44, defense. Half the distance to the goal, still third down.
The entire Spokane watch, the entire defensive front are all in the neutral zone, out of their stance, but no contact prior to the snap, so it's a free play for Kyle Rowley.
But as he threw it, Mike, everybody pulled up in their tracks. There must have been some whistle there because everybody stopped. Rowley, of course, didn't.
Or because of the awkwardness of the play, the assumption of a whistle on the player's part.
Good point. Brooks will be in high motion on third and goal from the three. Rally throws, incomplete. Intended for Brooks, it went high. Gilliam on the coverage, and fourth down awaits.
Gilliam on another key red zone breakup, and now this is decision time. Do you go field goal, or I think Coach Hohensee saying, nope, we're going for pay dirt.
Fourth down and goal from the three.
Well, this Spokane crowd clearly understands the situation. Ninth man getting very loud right now.
Two on the play clock. I don't think they're going to get it off. Rally does. Throws an incomplete. McMillan with tight coverage, and it's a turnover on down. There was no way McMillan was going to let that through.
Tight coverage. Outstanding job by McMillan. That inside arm, that left arm, across the face of the receiver and knocking that ball down. Clutch pass breakup on fourth down. Both teams now with red zone stops.
And Raleigh, who had been so red hot to start this ball game, 1 for 5 for 2 yards on that drive. Shock takeover from their own 3. First and 10, 2.5 to play in the quarter. Amos hit hard as he caught the football. Varma Soni came in with the tackle.
And a Thunder defensive lineman, I can't see the number, but down. Looks like a left knee area injury, lower leg injury in the Spokane end zone. They're number 8 again, Obi.
Obi with a pat on the back from Rory Nixon, the converted fullback who's got the center duties tonight. How about McMillan? He's a guy, and you hear about the secondary. Spokane has been begging and pleading for its defensive backs to go for the big play. Don't worry if you get burned. McMillan is one of those guys who's really answered. Last week, 2 more interceptions. That's 2 multi-interceptions games for him in 4 games overall with Spokane.
Absolutely, and that is the game plan with McMillan. Undercut routes when possible and go for the interception. If you give up a completion, so be it, but this game's about takeaways. Now let's see Obi coming down the left side. Watch the knee area, and it looks like a helmet or shoulder pad to that right knee, right or left knee.
You're gonna try to help
looks
him
like
up.
Like the left knee here.
Off the turf.
Yeah, he's favoring that left knee, but you can see it looked like just a contusion type injury is the cut block, not a chop block, cut block, which is legal. At the line of scrimmage where the knee.
Oh, he's hunting somebody out there.
Well, that was.
He does not like that.
That was Bryson Kelly who did the cut block. Now, chop block is when you're stood up by a lineman and then you're hit below the legs by a second lineman. That was just one-on-one called a cut block.
Either way, it doesn't feel good if you're the guy on the short end of that.
Not when your knee hits a shoulder pad or helmet. That will lead to contusions.
From the 9, it's 2nd down and 4. The give is to Kelly. He's going to fight for the yards, and he's going to be near the first down.
Just a dive up the middle for about 9 yards. That is just power football.
Dexter Davis came in like a torpedo, but unfortunately for him in Portland, he kind of helped Kelly towards the line of scrimmage and thus near the first down marker. It's going to be 3rd down and a short one.
And that running game, when you're pounding the defense, it physically takes its toll. And expect Spokane to run because with Obi out, they went right at the replacement, number 11, Dexter Davis.
Nelson gets the push from Kelly, of all people. So Kelly had a hand in on that play as Nelson picks up the first down.
Dexter Davis, 6'3", 230. And Spokane is saying, hey, with Obi out, we think the advantage is our running game, and we're just going to pound it at you, Portland.
And that'll take us to the 1-minute warning. Spokane trails by 13, but is driving 1st and 10 from their own 16 when we come back. Folks, here's a look at exactly what's at stake for Spokane and Portland, separated by just 1 game in the Pacific Division, 3 games to go in the regular season, and with the win tonight, Spokane can clinch at least the number 4 seed in the upcoming AFL postseason.
And keep in mind, Spokane and Portland have faced it. They will face each other 3 times, this being the rubber match, that they've split the 2 games. So this game is critical to both teams in these standings. Because of the tiebreaker.
We are now at the 1-minute warning. Spokane with the football from their own 16-yard line. Swing pass. This is Amos through the block by by Truesdale. Amos took it along the dasher board. With that, the clock stops with a 1-minute move.
Spokane with all 3 timeouts, and I expect Spokane to potentially roll out a couple runs on this drive. And if they do, I see him going right after the left defensive end, Davis.
Nelson on a bit of a roll right now. 2nd down and 2. That's Carter. Carter will pick up the first down. He'll He pushed forward even more so. Near the 20-yard line.
And the clock continues to tick. Apparently, he did not make it. Carter did not make it to the sideline, but with three timeouts, plenty of time for Spokane.
Interesting.
See, and Spokane is now going to use that timeout.
First and a half, 30 seconds of play.
Nelson now 9 for 13 for 68 yards. That's Carter's second catch, 2 for 19. Amish leading the way with 5 catches for 39 yards. No big play so far from the shot.
And do you have Rowley's updated numbers?
Yeah.
Very
no,
impressive first
he
half.
He started 9 for 10, Mike. He's now 14 of 19. He does have 119 yards passing.
This has been more of a grinded out kind of AFL game.
Nearly mirrored numbers between these two teams as far as scoring and on offense and on defense. This is Truesdale who will reach over the dasher board.
Nick Truesdale with the reception.
Big difference, though, of course, those two turnovers.
Game of about three.
But Mike, scoring seven offense, Spokane, 47.5 points per game. Portland scoring offense, 47.7 points per game. So they're separated by 0.2. In that category, scoring defense 55.9 for Spokane, 55.5 for Portland. Nelson's throw on the near side caught.
Truesdale
is tied up a little bit, now gets up.
And Olsen's going to use his second timeout.
30 seconds in play.
And Sam, you were going to go through the stats, offensive points per game, defensive points per game. Just looking at on paper, a virtual tie when you just go through the stat line for both teams. And the key one being, what are you doing putting points on the board?
Yeah, and I'll tell you, for Spokane, its biggest hurdle has been red zone offense, and for Portland, just taking care of the football. Drive continues after that timeout. Spokane with one timeout remaining. 22 seconds to play in the half. Third down and two from the Portland 13. Amos, the high motion man. The throw is into the end zone. It's caught by Truesdale over the wall. Did he hang on? He did. Six-foot-7, and he leapt through the roof to get that one. With 13 seconds to play in the half.
Perfectly placed ball by Nelson, and Truesdale, 6'7 frame, atoning for that fumble that put Spokane in this 20-7 hole. What a great play. We've seen some spectacular catches.
Rowan to make it a 6-point game, and he does. Nelson on the pump fake, throws, and Truesdale makes the catch. The wall is your friend in arena football.
The wall is equal to 2 feet as long as you secure the ball to the ground. Possession, touchdown.
You see the jersey, go see Gee. George Gee Hamster got a front row seat on that one.
Sure did. And some push-ups as well. Push-ups, 14 push-ups due. A push-up per point.
Relatively low scoring affair, but when you look at Portland and Spokane, that's the way their games have played out. We'll be joined by Nader Naini, the owner of the Spokane Shock, at halftime. So stay tuned for that. Lots going on in the Arena Football League and for the Spokane Shock. We'll be able to talk to Nader here at halftime.
Kicking off for the Shock is number 6, Taylor Rowland. Get a power right here, T-Row.
Mike, this isn't quite the run that Spokane put together to end the second quarter last week against Arizona, but similar situation where they trail 20-7. They sensed the tide needed to turn, and it did last week. It's starting to turn a little bit here tonight.
Well, and Rowan found a bar ball in this very similar situation last week about this point in the first half.
Rowan's kick is through the slack net with 13 seconds to play in the half. Mike, what do you think about the play of Kyle Rally so far?
I've been very impressed. You look at that, starting out 9 for 10, incredibly hot hand out of the blocks. Has cooled a bit, but overall, no interceptions, very efficient with the offense. A couple great plays by the Spokane D in the red zone to have that key stop when the score was 20-7. But overall, very nice play by Kyle Rally.
13 seconds to go. What do you do here if you're Portland?
Oh, you go for it. You sling it. You got two timeouts left. Use the entire field. If anything, maybe get that field goal back.
Rally from the end zone. They'll take a few seconds off the clock. Try to position themselves more so Rally can, presumably throw one off the net to end the half.
And we'll see what happens, but time for at least two more plays. And if it's a quick hitter to the sideline, that'll only take 2 or 3 seconds. So if you want to go quick hit to the sideline, quick hit to the sideline, then set up the Hail Mary or perhaps a field goal. Or just take your shots down the field, use your two timeouts that are left.
Jock not playing any prevent defense just quite yet. As there's your deep ball. McMillan on the coverage, incomplete. Pass was intended for Jared Perry.
And now, because you want a five-step drop, the length of the field on that was a five-second play. You've got no choice now but to go for it. You're well outside field goal range. So you're just going to have to take your shot if you're Spokane. Let's see if you can get to Rally and force a fumble. His Rally has been very clean back there tonight, not one sack yet.
No sacks and no turnovers. 4 seconds to play. Rally throws. They've got a receiver wide open in midfield as the clock will expire. McMillan with the stop on the catch by Perry, and that will do it for the first half of action. Through two quarters of play, Portland leads in Spokane against the Shock 20-14. Some fireworks, some touchdowns over the walls here tonight. We're in for a good one. When we come back, Nader Naini will join us. You're watching Shock Football live from Spokane. Sam Adams, Mike Peterson, thank you for joining us wherever you may be watching. Friends at Comcast Sportsnet Northwest picking this broadcast up for our Portland viewers. And, of course, here at home in the Spokane area. Mike, we had a heck of a first half.
It was a grinder of a game, and just what you would expect. I didn't expect either team would run away from the other. Very even matchup, and that is how it's played out in the first half. I expect more of the same in the second half.
The quarterback's pretty much dead even. Kyle Rally, former Spokane Shock signal caller, 16 of 22, 145 yards, a pair of touchdowns. Arvell Nelson, 12 of 16, 88 yards, one touchdown, though he did throw one interception. The leading receivers, Ashford, Lacey, and Brooks, all right around the same numbers, all between 26 yards and 37 yards. And then Anthony Amos leading the Shock with 5 catches for 39 yards.
Both quarterbacks with excellent distribution among their receivers. Rally getting more production than Nelson, 22 attempts, 145 yards. But it's the story of the first half of those two turnovers. That's the difference.
This kickoff sponsored by your locally owned Napa Auto Parts stores. Amos takes it off the net, barely out of the end zone, up to the 5-yard line. And that is where the Shock offense will take over. They won the coin flip. They deferred and now return and have the football to start the second half. Spokane with a win tonight secures a playoff spot. Portland with a win doesn't clinch a playoff spot, but gets a heck of a lot closer. Drive starts from their own 5-yard line. Arvell Nelson under center, throws over the middle. High throw and incomplete, and almost into the hands off that deflection. Defensive back, slow getting up off the turf.
Yeah, that was
Glanton. And he might have jammed his hand coming down.
And shoulder something, but he almost had that deflection.
Dangerous throw as Nelson tries to settle in.
Good coverage by the Thunder DBs.
Nelson on the run. Up to the 10 and to the 11-yard line. He's spotted down at the 12. Gain of 7 on the run by Arvell.
And between Nelson and Kelly, you've got a 1-2 punch with a mobile, big, strong quarterback in Nelson. Of course, we know what Kelly can do. Now, Pila is back in the game. He is now playing Mac linebacker. So if they run, expect left.
This is Carter. Carter will get the first down past the 20-yard line as Dexter Davis brought him down.
Davis, not quite the mass you have with Pila. Or I checked that with Obi. Obi going 6'2", 250, whereas Davis goes 6'3", 230.
Gain of 9. It's a first down and 10 from their own 20-yard line. Amos is the motion man. The throw is to Truesdale. Truesdale fighting for extra yardage. Will he get it? He will not. If he had simply extended his arm across that 20-yard line, he could have picked it up. Instead, he tried to pick up those extra yards with his feet.
Truesdale, when he catches short, especially intermediate, he tends to make his first step lateral or oftentimes retreat rather than just catching the ball. And sometimes you're better off just catching the ball north, south, and up the field. And as you said, if he stretched, that would have been a first down, Sam.
The give is to Kelly, and he'll easily pick up the first down. Bryson Kelly, the former Central Washington standout, with a gain of 6.
And it's going to be interesting to see if the physical toll of this running game is going to affect Portland Thunder. See guys already getting up a little slower, a little banged up, especially Pila in there at Jack linebacker.
Carter in high motion, the defense jumped. Here's a free play into the end zone. Carter cannot make the catch.
And Truesdale wide open down the left sideline. Nelson did not see him. That would have been like taking candy from a baby, but Nelson could not read it on the free play.
Offside, number 45, defense. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Still first down.
Credit Nelson for knowing he had a free play, though he did throw into coverage. He knew, hey, if they intercept it, it's not coming back, we'll have the football still.
And unfortunately, Nelson just did a rookie mistake and locked on to a single receiver. If he scanned the field, he easily would have seen Truesdale wide open down that left sideline.
He looks like Fernando Rodney after, you know, Rodney has a 4-run lead in the 9th and gives up a 3-run homer and kind of laughs it off and says, don't worry, I got this next one, coach. As long as you're in position to bounce back, that's what Nelson is looking to do here.
Well, and Nelson's got the right mentality. He's a what's next play mentality. He doesn't mope. He doesn't get down on himself on a bad play. He just shakes it off and moves forward.
So it's now a first down and 5 after that offsides penalty. Opening sequence here for Spokane, trying to take its first lead. The give is to Kelly. Kelly ran through one block and into the 5, down at the 3. Fresh set of downs for Spokane.
It doesn't matter where Kelly goes. He can go inside, outside, this one right up the gut. He's just quite a load, and he stays so low and also protects the ball very, very well. He does not fumble.
Inside the KFC red zone, fresh set of downs, first and goal from the 3. Kelly Gains 1.5. He's down. They mark him down somewhere between the 2 and the 1 yard line.
And I think you're going to continue to see him just give it to Kelly. That they've got it. Spokane has it going up the middle on those quick dives. I expect Kelly dive right, dive left. That A gap. The other option is Nelson on the quarterback keeper, but right now with Kelly's ability to get low with that head of steam, I like the dive play.
Second and goal from the 1. Nelson into the end zone for the score. Arvell Nelson on the touchdown run as he celebrates with his friend Anthony Amos.
And excellent play call, because you could see pre-snap Portland shifts to stuff the A gap. And sure enough, what's else Nelson do? Goes to the outside.
Nelson with his 5th rushing touchdown on the season, executed perfectly. He's done a better job of protecting the football here. It was the one thing watching him run these plays in practice, a little loosey-goosey. Ball goes off the bar and no good. So Spokane unable to take its first lead. We're tied up at 20 on the Arvell Nelson touchdown run as we look at our VPI Windows custom Fit for Life scoreboard. Hey, kind of guy.
Hey.
So between the two of us, we've got it covered. Uh-oh.
That would be goal line bandits.
So there's your daughter. Or unless you didn't want anybody to know.
No, that's fine. She's a social gal, loves her shock football, here with her friends.
Who's this guy?
Look at this.
What's up, dude?
Sam's kid. Got the families out tonight.
The sign down there, the cardboard sign that the goal line bandits are holding, says Portland sign.
Well, he called it. He called it. He knows his Spokane Chalk football.
Yeah, he knows how to read, too. Well, yep. He's a play-by-play guy, you know.
Oh, yeah, he was on it, Sam.
Yeah. Like, if you're a play-by-play guy, all you got to do is say what happens. It's the color guy that actually has to know what they're talking about.
I beg to differ. You're awfully good at what you do. I'm sitting next to a guy who's won 2 Emmys here, folks. So I am sitting here with a pro and honored to be part of this team.
Well, it's fun. And, when Nader said afterwards, he said, I meant it. I'm glad you guys are doing our games. The feeling is mutual. We genuinely enjoy every Friday and Saturday night. We're able to come out here to Spokane Veterans Memorial Arena. There is nothing better than arena football here in Spokane. So thank you, everybody who lets us do this. It feels like every week. Lacey with the catch. Second down and about 6 right now for Portland. Folks, we're all tied up at 20-20. Spokane trailed 20-7 in the second quarter. Didn't score its first points until the second quarter. And now we're tied up at 20 apiece. Kyle Rowley, the former shot QB, under center, throwing into coverage and almost intercepted by Sergio Gilliam. First poor decision we've seen from Rowley tonight.
It is, and Gilliam is very sure-handed, just jumped the route. You can see Rowley not seeing Gilliam. Rowley's not a very tall quarterback. He's in street clothes. He's not even over 6 foot tall, and so if you get the hands up and obscure his vision, that's where he could throw a lot of interceptions.
Third down and 6. Backed up from their own 9. Deep drop for Rowley. Throws! McCullough got a hand on it. The Jack linebacker, Kevin McCullough, used every bit of his range that he could to elevate and get that ball.
And there you go. A big push by Terrence Taylor up front. A lot of pressure. And Rowley, when that happens, not reading the field as well. And twice in a row, Rowley dodges an interception.
I know McCullough wishes and thinks that he should have had the interception, but I'll tell you what, that's just a great athletic effort and great timing on his part just to break it up. Fourth down and 6. Rowley to throw, and they whistle the play dead. There's a flag on the play. Was that a delay of game? It was.
and the hole just got a little deeper.
Half the distance to the goal, still fourth down.
Portland moving backwards now. They'll spot the ball inside the five. They need to get to the 15.
And most likely, Rally going to have to go to a five-step drop with 10 and a half yards to go. Loud crowd, tough time to make adjustments to the line of scrimmage. And you can bet the Spokane Shock front four are going to go at them.
And there's 8 seconds on the play clock. They're going to have to pick up their pace a little bit here. 3-2, they get it off. Rally throws through the hands of McMillan and incomplete. They're better off without the interception as they'll take over from the 5-yard line. McMillan, I know, is disappointed. He felt he should have had that one. He was thinking pick six the whole way.
Three potential interceptions from three different players and almost caught on the deflection by Perry, but Spokane, great field position in the red zone.
20-20 on your VPI Windows custom Fit for Life scoreboard. What does Spokane do here with fresh set of downs, first and goal from the five? Mike Peterson with the answer.
With 4.5 yards to go, I don't think you're going to see the ball in the air. I think you're going to see Kelly or Nelson, and Spokane just continue to try to pound this ball against Portland, and they've been pretty effective doing it.
And in the outdoor game, that's a no-brainer. On the indoor game, that is actually counter to what most arena teams do.
It absolutely is, but the Spokane offense has been revamped with the addition of Kelly at running back. I'll be surprised here on this first play if the ball's in the air. I expect a run.
Amos, the high motion man, the pitch is to Kelly. Kelly turns the corner and into the end zone. The downhill pitch looking like a mile high touchdown run from Terrell Davis. It's a touchdown for Bryson Kelly, and the Shock with 6:20 to play in the third have their first lead of the ball game. Kelly's second rushing touchdown gives the Shock the 6-point advantage.
And we've seen it all with the running game. Dive to the A gap, power play, power run to the B gap, and toss to the edge. It's all working tonight for Spokane in the running game. Of course, we've seen Nelson keep it and go around the end as well.
Seen two misses on PATs. Make it three. Well, we'll take the media timeout as Kelly scores, and the Shock have the lead with 5:48 to play in the third. As Kyle Rally goes, so do the Spokane Shock, though he doesn't even play for Spokane anymore. 14 of 15 for 126 yards, 2 touchdowns. That was the electric start for Kyle Rally, the former Shock. But since then, 3 for 11, 28 yards passing. And in that span, that 3 for 11 span, Spokane has scored 3 times. Meanwhile, 0 points for Portland in that duration. Return by Brooks. Tackled by McCullough and friends down at the 7.
Well, and Sam, if you break down that, you said it was a 3 for 11 span.
Yes.
3 opportunities for interceptions for Spokane. How many pass breakups and Spokane defenders getting the hand on the ball? It's like Spokane defense is now starting to figure out Kyle Rally, and with a little better push by the Spokane D-line and front four, Rally isn't quite getting the same looks as he had earlier.
Portland trails for the first time right now in this ball game.
Key for Spokane, watch nose guard, Terrence Taylor, 67. What kind of push does he get up the middle?
Rally's throw, this one picture perfect to Jared Perry. Simplify the game plan a little bit. Some extracurriculars going on. Well, as Terrence Taylor was getting into it with, John Martinez.
Yes, and Terrence Taylor just pinned his ears back, and that was a bull rush. Rally actually got knocked down because Taylor got a push right through the center and pinballed right into Kyle Rally.
Now, he's been warned by the league about the pancaking, but sometimes you can't avoid it.
Yeah, watch that nose guard push.
Taylor right through. And incomplete. Dodd Masters on the coverage. This was intended for Lacey. Dodd Masters never stops talking.
That's part of his game. It's part of his makeup.
He'll talk at the opponent. He'll talk with his teammates.
Yes. And it's pretty much nonstop.
Third down and four. Deep drop for Rally, little lob. And again, Taylor getting into it, this time with John Collins, the offensive lineman.
Terrence Taylor has found a second gear, perhaps a second win on this drive, and we're looking at another fourth down. And this pass rush is vicious when Terrence Taylor at nose guard continues at this, gets this kind of consistent push.
Rally after that 14 for 15 start, now just 18 of 29.
He's got the ability to just collapse the pocket from the middle.
Perry in high motion on fourth down. Four to go. Incomplete and a turnover on downs. Gilliam with the coverage. Timing is everything.
And Kyle Rowley and this Portland offense have not figured out the Spokane D as of late.
3:09 to play in the third. Spokane starting to roll here, leading by six. But Mike Peterson really struggling as of late.
Well, what's happened now is when Kyle Rowley was 14 of 15, it was a bunch of first and second downs. They never even got to third down. Well, on third down conversions, Portland 0 for 3 and 0 for 4. So if the Spokane D can get Portland in third and fourth down situations, advantage Spokane Shock.
Little flip. That was a live football, and somehow Carter wrestled that ball in. Again, 0 for 3 on third downs and on fourth down.
Yes.
That's been the difference here. Spokane, despite those two turnovers in the first half, now leading by six and a chance to make it a two-touchdown lead.
And combine that with, well, here we see that little shovel outside. Would have been interesting if Carter didn't corral it, whether they ruled that an incomplete pass or a fumble. That was close.
Nets 1 yard on the completion. Truesdell. Nowhere to go. Portland has really done a good job of bottling up Nick Truesdell. He really earns his money in the yards after the catch. And Truesdell has pretty much been contained so far as the big plays are concerned.
Now, interesting decision for Spokane here. Third and five. As effective as Spokane has been with the run, it would not surprise me to see Spokane go to the ground. I think it's a 50-50 call. Go to the air, give the ball to Kelly.
Truesdell in high motion. Nelson to throw, and it's Truesdell right on the first down marker. I think they're going to spot him half a yard shy. Let's see. Well, now they're saying immediately, they're indicating first down.
And I'm looking, I'm here on about the 4 or 5 yard line looking straight down, and Truesdell ran right into the line to gain. From my angle, it looked like Truesdell hit the first down marker. And they are giving him a first down now. But look at this. You'll see the marker. Now watch this. Watch Truesdell. He tucks it away, and boom, right there, right into the down marker. Okay. That's pretty conclusive.
Yeah. Well, especially when you look, you should be looking high. You should be looking low for the ball up high, but low where the stick actually is.
Yes, because there's the width of the stick itself, or like you said, up above.
Inside the KFC red zone. First and goal from the Portland 3. Nelson for touchdown number 3. Arvell Nelson into the end zone. The trifecta for him. Spokane has opened up a 2-touchdown advantage on its home field.
Well, there's your run, Sam. Fourth rushing touchdown for Spokane so far.
Nelson ran right into the end zone and inched his way further in afterwards to celebrate. Rowan. What a miss. And boy, is it in his head right now. And Patrick Afif is down on the turf and in significant pain. When Rowan is dialed in, I don't know if there's a better kicker in arena football. Right now, he can't get a connection.
It's been a rough year for Rowan, both PATs and field goals. But right now, the big story is equally big story, Afif. He's now Patrick Afif. He's on his feet now for Spokane, limping off.
Walking very gingerly. Talked to him earlier this week on Shock Talk. He had told me that after this season, his contract is up. He is seriously considering retiring, hanging it up. He's getting married. He's thinking about life after football. He will seriously ponder his future after this season.
He's just been a warrior, just a journeyman impact offensive lineman, has started every game for Spokane this season. So how's that for an Iron Man?
Yeah. Tell you, he battles out there, folks. And the offensive line has been very much in flux here this season. You see, of course, Rory Nixon getting the start at center. Gallanton has been thrust into the starting lineup. Tapua is out. Afif has been the one and only constant on that offensive line. And Rowan, meanwhile, has missed twice on points after. Kick is away and through the slack net. Arvell Nelson really starting to come on, folks, just like he did a week ago in that win against Arizona. That will do it for quarter number three.
The kick was unreturnable, therefore the penalty is declined by rule. First down, end of the third quarter.
Folks, when we come back, quarter number four, Spokane 32 and Portland 20. Quarter number four is upon us here in Spokane, Washington. Kyle Rally in and take a look at the Afif injury. Patrick Afif as he crumples to the turf.
There you see Nixon just taking on the Thunder defender and just rolled into that right leg, right knee area. But Afif walked off a bit gingerly, but on his own power. We'll see if he returns.
Rally, such a hot start, but his numbers now pedestrian, 18 of 30. Make that 19 of 31. Big completion there to Dwayne Brooks. Or excuse me, that's number six, Jared Perry.
Perry, the clearly the number one go-to receiver for Portland, and Rowley hanging in there. Big push again up front from Terrence Taylor, but Rowley able to get that ball off. I expect Portland to go with more of the one and three-step routes, the quick hitters, because these five-step routes, Spokane's getting too big a push right now.
23 yards. The longest of the day, intercepted by McMillan in the end zone. Mark McMillan, his fifth interception in five games with Spokane.
Portland going with the five-step drop. Ruffin with some pressure on the outside, a big push on the inside. Rally not stepping into that throw, floating it. What did McMillan do? Undercut for a pick.
Here is what makes Spokane so dangerous. They have figured this out, folks. They have said, you know what? We're going to give up big plays, but we're going to create turnovers. You saw the pass rush by Ruffin, forcing the early throw by Rowley. He knew as soon as he threw it, that one was trouble.
Rowley would be better advice just to simply throw that ball away there rather than throw it up for grabs. That was less than a 50-50 ball because he didn't step into his throw. Advantage McMillan made Rally pay.
From the five, this is Kelly. Bryson Kelly, nowhere to go. Driven into the turf by Adrian Hamilton.
It is textbook tackling by Hamilton. Talking about squaring up your pads and driving your legs. Kelly, who's a heck of a running back, just Flat got stood up and dominated on that one.
Well, you're a fan of that tackle. If Jeff Spicoli was here, he would say, way to go, Hamilton. Second down and 11 from their own four. Deep drop here for Arvell. Throws incomplete. Great coverage by Varma Soni, who has been very quiet tonight.
Blanketed Amos, AFL Offensive Player of the Week last week. Well over 100 yards, but Soni blanketing Amos on that play.
Soni on the other league exempt list while he was with the NFL's Cleveland Browns. Didn't report immediately after he was released, but he's been very good as of late. There's Truesdale with a catch. Then put right into the dasher board by Glanton. What a grab by that young man.
And Spokane counters, putting Truesdale in high motion and saying, okay, we're going to throw it high because you've got 6'7 Truesdale and about 5'8 Soni. That's a matchup that is very favorable to Spokane, and they went to it on a key third down.
19 yards on that conversion. Just a yard shy of midfield from the 24. Here's Amos. Great block by Truesdale into the 15. Ball loose and into the hands of Truesdale. And Amos is not getting up.
Amos got stood up and stripped. And couldn't tell what from here, what kind of shot he took. But obviously, by the way he's laying on the ground, he took some sort of shot because it knocked the ball loose. Spokane got lucky.
Amos says, that's on me. Let's see what he saw.
And you see Truesdale out front blocking. This is a really nice play for Spokane. Knee was down. That would have been reviewable anyway. Sure looked like the knee was down and then the ball was stripped. But with Spokane recovering, no sense throwing the red flag.
First and 10, Spokane from the Portland 11. Nelson on the run. And a lot of quarterbacks just throw away the football there. And there's a lineman. Is that Nixon? That's a FIFA again.
And they're adamantly calling for a trainer. This does not look good.
Everyone around him taking a knee right now. Media timeout. We're going to take a media timeout. This does not look good for Patrick Afif.
Some more watches. It's time for the Pounders Jewelry Kiss Cam. Shock fans and sweethearts, we need to see some people kissing for your chance to win.
Afif has hobbled off the field under his own power, it should be noted. So they'll rotate a new offensive lineman in, and they're ready thin at that position as Banks comes in. Larry Banks Jr., the last man on the depth chart for Spokane. Second down and 5 from the 6. Pump fake throw into the end zone, tipped off the net and incomplete. Intended for Nick Truesdale.
That ball need to be a little more touch up and over the top rather than I just see too much zip on that pass. When you've got Truesdale, you want just a little bit of loft to take advantage, full advantage of that 6'7 frame. But very good coverage by the Portland defender. That's a tough matchup.
Truesdale, high motion man. Throw is to Truesdale. They're going to try it again. This one, same thing. No touchdown, incomplete. Is there?
And there's your matchup. They go two receivers left. Truesdale, one-on-one, high motion right against Soni. Soni wins the battle.
And Mike, it's decision time right now. They have a kicker who hasn't made 2 points after. But just outside a running range, that's where Spokane has shined here inside the red zone.
Well, Rowan has been inconsistent. A field goal makes it 15 points. Still a two-possession game. You have to go for a touchdown here. I agree with the call.
They're going to have to take the timeout. They almost lost the play clock. They would have taken a delay of game, which would have turned a 4th and 5 into a 4th and 10.
Now, if a field goal turns it into a 3-possession game, different story, decision time, but meaningless right now. Can only bump you to 15-point lead. head coach Mike Cohen's seat and doubles as the offensive coordinator for the Portland Thunder.
I mean, he's seen it all. I mean, here's a guy who you played against him in college. He was at the University of Minnesota. And if you can think of a league name, AFL, NFL, CFL, I mean, he's been there, done that.
25 years of history. There he is with Mike Ditka. Actually played two games in the strike season way back in the day. I believe that was 1987. Started two games for the Bears. And there's his USFL card with the Federals. Boy, that goes way back. And the Toronto Argonauts there on the left. So CFL, AFL, NFL. Sam, when you said he's seen it all, indeed.
Fourth and five after the timeout. Nelson with time throws a dart into the end zone and it's intercepted. This one might be going back. A long return past midfield. And what a clutch interception for the Portland Thunder and Amon Glanson.
Well, as equally important as the interception on fourth down is just coming up with a stop, and that interception gives Portland phenomenal field position. And you can see it just had the angle on Truesdell. Again, if you've got Truesdell, have some loft on it and throw it to the outside of the dasher board. Don't try to zip that in. The angle was not there. The window to throw to was not there. That was a poor decision by Nelson.
And Nelson was the one who made the touchdown saving tackle on the return. Will this be what Raleigh needs to get back on track? From the 22, they run a screen pass, and this might go for a touchdown. Multiple flags coming in on the catch by Lacey.
Now, we talked about a cut block. You can do it on the line of scrimmage, but not out in the open field. So Dodd Masters got cut blocked by the wide receiver. That drew the flag. This play is coming back. No open
personal
field.
Foul. Illegal block number two by the high motion man. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Still first down.
I mean, special teams in open field, you cannot cut block.
Here's a look.
You'll see the cut block right there.
Dodd Masters got taken out. That's where the flag came in.
And that's the reason. That's a personal foul. That results in way too many injuries. Full speed, high motion, and you're cutting the guy's knees. Oh my goodness. Dangerous.
Marching Portland backwards now inside their own 20-yard line. Spot the ball at the Thunder 19. First and 20. Incomplete, thrown behind Perry, who created a lot of room underneath.
And perhaps that ball may have been deflected. The Spokane front four is really starting to assert themselves, just like they did against Arizona last year. That the game changer for Spokane in that upset victory over Arizona was the front four creating pressure.
Mike, we're talking about a start with Raleigh in his first 15 attempts where he was over 90%. He now is barely above 50% for the ball game on completion percentage. Raleigh over the middle, low throw, caught. It's short of the first down at the shot 17, caught by Perry.
That's a big play, and Portland, second and long, has to go to the five-step drop. Got really good protection for Raleigh, and a very productive second down play.
14-yard pickup sets up a third down and a manageable five. Third and five from the Spokane 17. Portland trails by 12, 7:45 to go in this ball game. Raleigh throws. There's a flag. McMillan will take the pass interference.
Yep, McMillan undercutting, taking a shot. Raleigh throwing the ball with a little loft over the top. McMillan said, hey, rather than giving up a potential
pass
touchdown,
number 26, tug. Defense, half the distance to the goal, automatic, first down.
You'll see McMillan undercut. Watch that left arm.
Good sell job by Perry, too.
And there goes the hanky.
This is a big possession right now for Portland to climb back in. 7.5 minutes to play. First and goal from the Shock 9-yard line. Lob caught by Martinez in stride. John Martinez, the offensive lineman, makes that catch, and it's a one possession ball game.
Well, they missed, officials missed potentially an ineligible downfield because that was the tight end, or no, that I take that back, that was the fullback who caught the ball.
Yes.
So that was the tight end who was down the field. So nope, clean play, nothing was missed. Tight end on one side, fullback on the other.
Very important PAT. High snap, and it's good. How about the composure of the place kicker? Ramirez converts after the touchdown pass from Rally. Portland is back within five on the VPI Windows Custom Fit for Life scoreboard.
Really liked the play call. You had McDonough, number 9, the tight end, going to the right side, and Martinez out of the backfield to the left side. That's five receivers in the route, and Rally making the right decision. That is beautifully designed and well blocked up front.
Ramirez, the kick. Dodd Masters is back to return in place of Anthony Amos. Dodd Masters, a great return, past the 15-yard line. So now the question is Anthony Amos coming into the game at wide receiver? I do not see any sign of number 5.
There he is.
So I don't know if Anthony might have earned his way into the doghouse just a little bit after that interception that was at the goal line. The first thing I saw, Andy Olson was getting into the face of not Truesdale, the intended man, not the quarterback Nelson, but number 5, Anthony Amos. So it'll be first down and 10, Spokane from their own 18-yard line.
Carter, Truesdale, and Amos, Spokane's wide receivers.
5-point ball game. Nelson throws on the run, perfectly thrown, and Carter makes the catch. Getting into it a little bit with 21, Dwight McClain.
Oh, it's going to get chippy. I expect it to be chippy now. This game means too much. They've seen each other 3 times this year. Nelson doing a nice job sensing the pass rush because Davis was coming hard on the right side and rolled right and then just dumped it over the top of the Jack linebacker. You see, senses the pressure. You'll see Davis coming and threads it in.
Rally type play, nets him 9 yards, and Nelson will push forward down to the 20 and a first down. You know, you talk about the game getting chippy. Between the fans, it's been very civil between Portland and Spokane. We have a great Portland contingent here on hand. We understand that the Spokane Shock fan club actually had those Portland Thunder fans out there for some pregame tailgating.
And those Portland Thunder fans are with the notorious goal line bandits. You see the goal line bandits first few rows and the Portland fans behind them. Great sportsmanship tonight.
Here's a throw into the end zone into coverage and batted away. It was intended for Truesdale. And out of nowhere came Glanton to swat that away like Dikembe Mutombo, like it was 1994.
There you go. Truesdale on the corner route. Nelson trying to fit it in into double coverage and not going to happen.
Now we can blame the Portland fans, though, for the bullhorns or vuvuzelas or whatever you want to call them. Other than that, it's been fun having them. Second down and 10. Nelson on the pump throws. He's got a man wide open. It's Anthony Amos for the score. That old shoulder fake, creating just enough space as Amos, a couple handshakes, and a touchdown.
Yeah, there's Amos, high motion. That's how you get down the field that quickly after the snap, and there you go. Little pump, little touch, 6 points.
20 yards on that touchdown pass.
Now can Rowan figure out his PAT kicking because it's been a zoo tonight.
Good snap, good hold, nearly blocked. And Rowan getting maybe the loudest cheer of the night for that make. What a grab by Amos. Some great route running setting that one up. 39-27. Spokane answers with 3.5 to play. Five plays, 32 yards on our VPI Home Solutions scoring recap. Arvell Nelson, his second touchdown pass of the evening. This one going 20 yards to Anthony Amos.
And as you saw that shot of Nelson, you could see him talking about, yep, I did that little shoulder pump fake, and just as Sam called it, it was designed by Nelson. A big answer for Spokane against Portland.
Amos, tell you about a guy who has really stepped it up this season. He's an AFL rookie, but he's been playing this season like he's a five-year veteran.
Ever since game two, he has been a starter. He is no longer a rookie. He is now a bona fide veteran.
Dwayne Brooks back to return. Kyle Rowley has figured the kicking thing out. See if he can hit a bar here. It's off the net. Brooks on the return. He's got Rowley to beat, and he's going to take it in for the touchdown. There is a flag on the play back towards the line of scrimmage. Somebody might have jumped off sides on the kicking unit.
And it'll be costly if it's Portland. Most of the time, you're going to see that against the kickoff
offsides,
team.
Offsides, number three, kicking team. That penalty is declined. Touchdown.
Well, talk about an answer for Portland.
Oh, he's a great returner. And that was great blocking and just north-south untouched. And just a speed burner.
Portland gets the ultimate answer. Didn't even have to touch the ball offensively. The all-important point after to get it back within five. And it's through and good with 3 minutes to play. Hang on to your hats, folks. This one may come down to the final whistle. Here's a look at the return.
Yeah, you're talking about just going north and south, and look at the speed. Absolutely untouched. Someone broke down the lane. I guess he did get grazed by Taylor Rowan. That's just going to be a no contest. Brooks off to the races.
Great blocking to create that wedge. And it's back to a five-point ball game. 3 minutes to play. Now, Spokane and Portland both with significant playoff implications. The Shock have the number three seed right now in the National Conference, tied with Las Vegas. They both have overall records of five wins. Of course, Las Vegas, though, have basically 5.5 wins when you think about it. Their game last week, or was it this week?
This weekend
against New Orleans was canceled because both teams are now under league ownership. So instead of having two league-owned teams playing each other with, I guess, some sort of, you know, obviously, I honestly can't say what the exact reasoning behind it is other than they don't feel like it would be a fair game. So they canceled the game. They gave each team a tie instead. That's muddied the waters even more as the playoff picture moves.
This is looking like Portland's teeing up for an onside kick. So hold your horses. This is when it gets exciting.
Truesdale. Did he get in?
Not quite.
He's done that time and time again. Nick Truesdale, folks, you've seen him as a wide receiver, but if you've been watching these games in person or on TV, you know how big he is on this hands team.
And that's by design. You see the front blockers or the front line guys for Spokane seeking a Portland player so Truesdale can come in, use that big frame, and clean up behind him. He did that last week against Arizona. Went very high on a pop-up kick.
They're on the two. This is the KFC red zone.
Yeah, and this is on the two. This is Kelly Nelson time. I think this ball is going to stay on the ground.
Give is to Bryson Kelly. Kelly is stopped. Bryson
Kelly. And by keeping it on the ground, you don't have the incompletion, and the clock goes tick, 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 tick. A little bit of
positive yardage there, but it's assume the goal, down. Mike, here would be for Spokane to try to take it down to the 1 minute warning. This play here, this snap will take him inside of 2 minutes. If they take it down to four plays, they can take it with no incomplete passes. They could take it down to the one-minute mark.
With a touchdown, a two-possession lead, you can't get cute as Spokane. You need points. I say just continue to pound it up the middle.
Remember, the clock will continue to run even after the touchdown. Just a little bit. Here's Nelson. He stopped at the five. Well, that opens up the playbook, if anything, right now for Spokane. They have to seriously consider throwing the football here.
Yeah, and that worked earlier with Portland defense keying off Kelly going up the gut. This time Nelson tried to go outside, and that's a very big negative yardage play in the red zone. Spokane has to consider passing now. And I think Spokane's going to run it down. And what, just as it hits zero on the play clock, they're going to call timeout.
Congratulations to Jim in section 115, row two.
So they take it down to 1 minute and 19 seconds, which, whether it's a touchdown for Spokane. Now, if it's an incomplete pass, obviously the clock stops, but they should be able to take it down to 1 minute.
Yeah, if you're Spokane, you've got to go to your best plays down here and get this up to a two-possession game. You can't afford to run the ball, let it go down to 1 minute, and then fail to score on fourth down. You have to execute and get points. Spokane failed on their first trip to the red zone and have converted and have been 4 for 4 since.
Going out in section 115 and 114, those are the last backs that we've
done.
So congratulations. Thank you very much. We do appreciate you.
Head coach Andy Olson doubling his offensive coordinator, talking it over with Arvell Nelson, quarterback.
Third down and goal from the five. Spokane with the football. Trying to salt this one away. Amos is the motion man. Nelson trying to throw. He gets rid of the football. Great pursuit there by 45, Adrian Hamilton. And now, Mike, they bring out Taylor Rowan.
Well, if Rowan does convert, it forces Portland, and now we got the one-minute rules. Talk about it when we come back, Sam.
So the one-minute warning is upon us, 39-34, and a big field goal coming up for Taylor Rowan.
Well, I agree with Andy Olson. If Rowan is successful, it's an eight-point game. The worst that can happen if Portland goes down and scores, force a two-point conversion, you've at least secured a tie in overtime. But again, in one-minute rules, who knows what's going to happen, because we've seen 3-4 different possessions in one-minute rules.
Now remember, any miss is a live ball. Kick is away and good. Never a doubt about it. Taylor Rowan dialed back in, and the lead stands now at 8. That had the pucker factor.
Yes, it did. Like a free throw being shot in the kennel in basketball. Everyone gets really quiet. It was very quiet here in the arena.
So Rowan successfully makes that field goal after two missed PATs. And the lead stands at 8, 54 seconds to play. Well, you're going to see a sigh of relief until this game is over from either team.
Oh, this is the beauty, as we look at the goal line bandits, the beauty of the AFL game. You just don't know what's going to happen. It's just crazy. And these unique one-minute rules, it's so different than the outdoor game.
The GLBs, as they're known, they've been here every single game.
Since 2000. Six. They've been here since the inaugural season through thick and thin.
There's the veteran, Richard Dodd Masters. He's been a player, he's been a coach on this team.
And then back to player again.
Yep. Rowan will kick, 54 seconds on the clock. Brooks is back to return. Remember, he sprung one loose his last time he returned. Through the slack net, he will get no return this time.
And that's a second clutch pick by Taylor Rowan, finding the slack net and keep the ball away from Brooks, who is oh so dangerous.
Crowd on its feet here in Spokane.
And this is going to be a factor for the Portland offense. If Kyle Rowley has to go no huddle and trying to bark out signals, there's a reason it's called DEAF, D-E-A-F Valley. And this place is getting loud, and they know the situation.
Portland with two timeouts remaining. This drive starts from its own 5-yard line. Former shot QB, former Arena Bowl MVP, Kyle Rowley under center. Quick throw. Dasher boards. Lacy the catch.
Stops the clock.
And Derek Summers able to pull his way through and get a hurry and a knockdown on Rowley, but a quick hitter out to the sideline. Efficient first down play. Two timeouts for Portland.
Portland trying to climb back in the playoff picture. After that 2-1 start, really struggled in May, June, and in July. Just one win since May the 23rd. Pass caught by Perez Ashford. It'll move the chains, and clock moves. He did not reach the dasher board. And a quick spike. Now there's a flag on the play.
And I'm not sure Portland was in alignment. This may go against Portland for illegal formation or procedure. That spike came awfully quick.
Illegal formation. Defense wasn't set in a 3-point stance. They're going to be in the bonus for Portland. 5-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, there you go. Portland able to successfully get in alignment. Spokane wasn't ready. And if you're a defensive lineman, you've got to be in a stance. You have to have a hand on the ground. Spokane unable to get a hand on the ground.
And that's a veteran move by Kyle Rowley.
And good job of the offensive unit to get up there and set themselves quickly, because that happened in a flash. Well
First
done.
And 10 from the 25. Deep drop for Rowley. Throws under duress into the end zone. Juggled and caught for the touchdown. Jared Perry with 29 seconds. And now Portland is a 2-point conversion away from tying this thing up. 25 yards on the touchdown pass from Rowley. And folks, we're going down to the wire here in Spokane.
And that drive only consumed 25 seconds. Portland started actually on the kickoff, or started that drive with 54 seconds on the play clock. So, huge play.
Rally's fourth touchdown pass, 6 on the play clock, directing traffic. Lacy in motion, this to tie. Flag on the play, receiver wide open, Lacy.
This is going to go against Portland.
False start, number 79, offense. 5-yard penalty.
That's John Collins, the offensive lineman, with the false start. Costly. 6 points don't mean much if you can't get 8.
Changes the playbook a little bit. You're going to have to go to the 5-step drop.
And this is where Spokane really relishes on defense. They love that 5-step. Put some heat on the quarterback with that vaunted front 3.
Watch Terrence Taylor in the middle. Does he get a push?
Rush coming, throw, a little wobbly, and incomplete. Perry wants a flag, he won't get it. McMillan on the coverage, and now it's 42-40 after the missed 2-point conversion. Are you having fun yet?
I know I am.
Now here's the thing, Portland tried the onside kick before. Truesdell was there. I know you have to kick in a certain direction, but you've got to make sure you don't kick it to 81.
you have really two legitimate choices, a pop-up kick or a little squibber. The squibber takes Truesdell out of the equation for Spokane, but odds are you're better off with a pop-up kick, but with someone like Truesdell, it's strategy time. But I expect one or the other. I don't expect the pooch that would go 20, 25 yards down the field, and then it's just a sprint and a foot race to try to track it down. I expect a squib or a pop-up. And we'll see where he places the ball.
It all comes down to an onside kick for the Portland Thunder, who have beaten Spokane just once in five games in this all-time series.
He's going to pop-up land. Far, far left hash mark, about even with the numbers.
There's the guy you don't want to kick it to. 81, Nick Truesdell, 6'7". There's your pop-up. Truesdell has it, and he'll sit on it, and that's going to do it. Now, Portland still has two timeouts remaining, Mike. This game is not over.
No, because Spokane must get positive. In two-minute rules, you must get positive yardage, so no gain or a negative yardage play by the Spokane offense stops the clock, just like an incomplete pass.
Now, the Shock have run the ball very well tonight, but Mike, that has come when the defense didn't necessarily see it coming. Portland will be pinning its ears back here, knowing the ball will be on the ground.
You're going to see Nelson on a quarterback keeper to the A gap, a dive by Kelly to the A gap, or maybe a power to the B gap. You're not going to see end run.
Nelson, they're saying he got positive yardage. So Portland will have to expend its second timeout, one remaining.
So Spokane needs two positive yardage plays, and this game will be over.
One, of course, would end with a timeout. The other would take it down to zero.
But Spokane had this situation last week against Arizona, did not convert on a fourth down, and so Arizona had the ball with about 5 seconds to go. So we say anything can happen in this AFL game. And you can bet Portland defenders are going to be tugging at that ball. I think Spokane's just going to stick to the A-gap.
Nelson over the top. Forward progress. Down to the 8. Clock stops with 16 seconds, and Portland uses its final timeout.
Now, if you're Portland, what you want to do is stand up the runner, and then it gives you a shot to just rip that ball loose. So whether it's Nelson or whether it's Kelly, as soon as you get positive yardage, you've got to get low underneath the defenders and just fall forward to the ground, because if you get stood up, it could be ripped out for a fumble.
And that's where Eric Meyer was so good with Spokane back in his Arena Football League MVP days. Arvell tries to get low and forward. He does just that, and that will do it. Spokane hangs on by the skin of its teeth, 42-40, and with that win has clinched his spot in the 2015 AFL playoffs. And it comes on Fan Appreciation Night, the final home game of this 2015 regular season. There's Warren Smith giving congratulations to the new starting quarterback and Rashard Dodd Masters. A shout out to the fans as Spokane rallies back from 13 points down to win it 42-40.
Call the Shock at 242-7462. Attorney of Shock Ticket Department will take care of your
time to announce tonight's player of the game, presented by Triple Play Family Fun Park, where fun is always in season. Player of the game, Arvell Nelson. Big handshake from his head coach, Andy Olson. Nelson, two rushing touchdowns and two passing touchdowns. Nelson now 2-0 as a starting quarterback in the Arena Football League.
The starting role has served Nelson and the Spokane Shock very well.
Folks, when we come back, It's our post-game show. Spokane headed to the postseason with two games to spare. 42-40 the final here from Spokane. As we invite you, wherever you may be, in Portland or here in Spokane, to watch the post-game show. We'll wrap things up when we come back. The final, 42-40, Spokane over Portland.